New research offers hope in controlling a deadly pathogen, E. coli O157.H7. These bacteria, carried by cattle, are a dangerous source of food poisoning and a concern for those who work in beef production and food safety. Researchers at the Kansas State University College of Veterinary Medicine have completed a study demonstrating the efficacy of a vaccine for this type of E. coli in commercial feedlots.
E. coli O157.H7 is one type of E. coli that happens to carry genes that produce Shiga toxins. So these are called Shiga toxin producing E. coli. The importance of this particular type of E. coli is it's a serious human pathogen. So in cattle, E. coli O157 is part of the normal bacterial flora of the gastrointestinal tract. And these animals that carry that particular type of E. coli in the gut shed the organism in the feces, which then subsequently could contaminate the food and water. And that's how humans get exposed to the pathogen.
Doctors David Renter and T.G. Nagaraja led a study related to two products, a vaccine produced by Pfizer Animal Health and a probiotic feed additive called bovamine. The products were tested for their ability to reduce the prevalence of E. coli O157.H7 in cattle. This study was unique for the fact that it was carried out at a large commercial feedlot.
Our objective was really to work with a large-scale commercial cattle feeding operation with a population of cattle that we expected to have a very high level of E. coli O157, and see if interventions that were commercially available, people could buy them off the shelf, how well they worked. The bottom line is the vaccine worked really well given the situation that we put it in.
While the study found the probiotic additive did not have any benefits, the vaccine significantly reduced the amount of E. coli O157.H7 in cattle. This success was even more pronounced in cattle known as super shedders. These are the 10-15% of O157 positive cattle that shed 1,000 times more bacteria than other positive cattle. These super shedders are the major source of contamination.
When I started doing work on E. coli O157 more than 10 years ago, if people asked me, producers asked me, what can we do to try to reduce E. coli O157 in our herds, in our feedlots, in our pens, we really didn't have an answer. We said, well, you could do this, you could do that, but up until fairly recently, over 10 or 15 years, we really didn't have an answer. Now we're at a point here where we say, here's something that works.
The researchers are excited about finding tools for combating E. coli O157.H7, but emphasize there's more research that needs to be conducted.
We have found there are other types of E. coli that produce the same toxin that are also causing human illnesses. So we're working on diagnostic methods to be able to detect, isolate these organisms from cattle and study the characteristics. That way we can compare those to E. coli O157.
K-State is actively involved in a 5-year, $25 million USDA-coordinated agriculture project grant with several institutions such as the University of Nebraska. This grant unites microbiologists, food scientists, and even statisticians in E. coli research and outreach education. Researchers at the College of Veterinary Medicine are currently focused on pre-harvest food safety or health issues that occur prior to slaughter.
We feel this multidisciplinary approach would be the best way to tackle this problem. And hopefully at the end of 5 years, we would know more about the 7 different types of E. coli and understand the ecology of those in cattle and their environment. And the goal would be to develop practical on-farm strategies to minimize the prevalence of these pathogens in cattle.
To learn more about E. coli and other research at the College of Veterinary Medicine, please visit the college's website.